हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर न्यू पॉइंट जनरल सेकेंड डिग्री इक्वेशन। जनरल सेकेंड डिग्री इक्वेशन इन x and y. Okay, now see, the equation is of the form, the equation is of the form ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0, where at least one of a, h, b is not zero, and this equation is called general second degree equation in terms of x and y. Okay, now see, we know that the combined equation of two lines we get always in the two form. First is the homogeneous second degree equation, and second form is general second degree equation. Okay, and this form we already learned. Now see, the general second degree equation, and this equation is also known as a non-homogeneous equation. Okay, it is a non-homogeneous equation in x and y. Okay, in the previous lecture we already find, we know that the two lines, see here, the two lines are passing through origin. Here is the line u is equal to 0, here is the line v is equal to 0. Okay, just as the both line या ओरिजिन मधून पास होत असतील तर त्यांचं कंबाइंड इक्वेशन आपल्याला मिळतं होमोजिनियस सेकंड डिग्री इक्वेशन. अँड सपोज वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर टू लाईन्स डू नॉट पास थ्रू ओरिजिन. सी हियर, इन रेक्टॅंग्युलर कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टीम वी हॅव टू ड्रॉ टू लाईन्स. हियर इज दी फर्स्ट लाईन and here is the second line. Equation of this line is u is equal to 0, and equation of this line is v is equal to 0, and these two lines are do not pass through origin. Then the combined equation of these two line get general second degree equation. Now see, in a general second degree equation, how to identify this type of equation? The highest degree of at least one term in this equation is 2. म्हणजेच दिलेल्या इक्वेशन मध्ये कमीत कमी एका टर्मची डिग्री, हायएस्ट डिग्री ही जर 2 असेल तर त्या इक्वेशनला आपण म्हणतो जनरल सेकंड डिग्री इक्वेशन, अँड इट इज अ नॉन होमोजिनियस इक्वेशन. वी नो दॅट दी होमोजिनियस इक्वेशन मीन्स डिग्री ऑफ एव्हरी टर्म इज सेम, बट इन दॅट केस डिग्री ऑफ एव्हरी टर्म इज नॉट सेम, अँड दॅट टाईप ऑफ इक्वेशन इज नोन ॲज अ नॉन होमोजिनियस इक्वेशन. नाव सी दि थेरम, the combined equation, combined equation of two lines is general second degree equation in x and y. Okay, so see, the proof of this theorem is not important. Okay, now first of all, for finding the combined equation of two lines, general second degree equation in x and y, first of all we have to consider two lines, but they are do not pass through origin, and we know that the equation of line do not pass through origin is let u is equivalent to first line take a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0. Second line we take a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Now their joint, that is a combined equation, joint equation is, we know that take a product of these two equations, we get a combined equation u into v is equal to 0. We know that the equation u is here a1x plus b1y plus c1 into a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Now take a product of these two brackets here, a1x into a2x, we get a1 a2x square plus a1x into b2y, get a1 b2xy plus product of first term and third term is here a1 c2x. Now take a second term, multiple of this bracket, we get b1 a2x, b1 a2y plus product of this term is here b1 b2y square. Now plus first and last term, product is b1 c2y plus third term into multiplication of this bracket is c1 a2x plus c1 b2y plus c1 c2 is equal to 0. Now we can write this equation a1 a2x square plus take a common factor of this term and see here, product of this term is here b1 a2, b1 a2 here is the x into y. Okay, now product, take a common factor of this term is xy, in bracket we can write a1 b2 plus b1 a2 xy plus b1 b2 y square plus take a common factor of this term and this term is x, we can write a1 c2 plus c1 a2 x plus take a common factor of this term and this term is y, we can write in bracket b1 c2 plus c1 b2 y plus constant take as it is c1 c2 is equal to 0. Now we know that product of two constant we get the any other constant, and sum of two constant we get the any other constant. Okay, now here we can put here our general second degree equation is ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. So put a1 a2 is equal to a, then a1 b2 plus b1 a2 is equal to 2h, b1 b2 is equal to b, then this bracket we can put a1 c2 plus c1 a2 is equal to 2g, then b1 and C1 C2 is equal to C. Okay, now this equation we can write here: ax square plus 2hxy plus dy square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Okay, and this is the general second degree equation in x and y, and this is the proof of this theorem. But proof of this theorem is not important. Okay, now see the important note is here note is, first note is the converse of above theorem is not converse of above theorem is not true. Okay, see, we know that जर दिलेल्या दोन lines या do not pass through origin असतील तर त्यांचं combined equation हे आपल्याला काय मिळतं, general second degree equation in x and y. But दिलेलं equation जर general second degree equation असेल तर ते प्रत्येक वेळी दोन line pair of line represent करेलच असं नाही. Okay, now see, the converse of above theorem is not true because every general second degree equation in x and y need not represent a pair of lines. Okay, now see the example. We can write the example x square plus y square is equal to 100. Okay, now see, this is the general second degree equation because at least one of the term of highest degree is here 2. म्हणजे कमीत कमी एका टर्मची जी डिग्री आहे ती 2 आहे आणि ती डिग्री तुमची काय पाहिजे, हायेस्ट डिग्री. बट दिलेलं जे इक्वेशन आहे इट डज नॉट रिप्रेझेंट अ पेअर ऑफ लाईन्स. ओके, नाउ दिस इक्वेशन रिप्रेझेंट हियर इट रिप्रेझेंट अ सर्कल. ओके, now see, suppose we have to give the equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Okay, this equation, a equation teen form represent karnar ahe. Tatla pahila form ahe tumcha pair of lines. Okay, second form is this equation represent a circle, and third form is this equation represent a conic section. Conic section, that is hyperbola, parabola and ellipse. But in this topic we have to learn what is the equation represent a pair of lines. Okay, now see how to identify the equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0 represent a pair of line. Okay, हे equation कोणत्या condition ला pair of line represent करणार आहे, ही condition काय करायची आपल्याला या ठिकाणी represent करायची आहे. Now see the condition, necessary condition for general second degree equation. Okay, condition for The equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0 represents a pair of lines. Okay, if right now the first condition is x square minus ab is a greater than or equal to 0, and second condition is here abc plus 2fgh plus minus af square minus bg square minus ch square is equal to 0. After satisfying these two conditions, the given equation represents a pair of lines. Okay, now see this condition, we can express it in the form of a determinant. That is, we can write this condition, we can express the in the determinant AHG HBF GFC is equal to 0. म्हणजे ही कंडिशन आपण फक्त डिटर्मिनंट फॉर्म मध्ये लिहिली आहे. एंड हाउ टू रिमेंबर दिस डिटर्मिनंट, रिमेंबर दिस स्टेटमेंट, अ हॅपी गर्ल हॅविंग ब्युटिफुल फेस गो फॉर कॉलेज. ओके, नाउ राइट डाउन दिस कंडिशन. Now see the remark. All these remarks are very, very important. If the equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0 represents a pair of lines, then see here we have to give the general second degree equation, it represents a pair of lines. Then see the first remark is these lines are parallel to the line represented by the equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square is equal to 0. Okay, now how to express this condition? See here, suppose we have to consider two lines. See here, in the rectangular coordinate system, first we take a two lines, they are do not pass through origin. Okay, now see these two lines are not pass through origin. Here is the line u is equal to 0, here is the line v is equal to 0. Okay, we can draw two lines, they are pass through origin. Suppose we can draw the line parallel to u is equal to 0. U ला parallel असलेली line या ठिकाणी जर आपण काढली, this is the line parallel to u is equal to 0. Second line is here. We can draw parallel to v is equal to 0 is here. figure. Here is the line. U is equal to 0. Here is the line. B is equal to 0. We know that these two lines are do not pass through origin. And combined equation of these two lines is get a general second equation. And in that case, we can draw the line U is equal to 0. Parallel to U dash is equal to 0. These two lines are parallel. Okay? Now see. V is equal to 0 is parallel to V dash is equal to 0. Okay? Now, these two lines are also parallel. Okay? Now, see here. We know that the combined equation of these two lines is get a general second degree equation. And the lines are parallel to V equal to 0 and V equal to 0. Is here U dash is equal to 0 and V dash is equal to 0. Okay? But these two lines are passing through origin. So, we get the combined equation of these two lines here. Ax square plus 2hxy plus dy square is equal to 0. Now see, the acute angle between. We can find acute angle between these two lines here. Theta. Okay? So, in that case, here is the angle. We get also theta. Because U is equal to 0 is parallel to U dash is equal to 0 and V is equal to 0 is parallel to V dash is equal to 0. Now see, the second remark is acute angle between them is tan theta is equal to, we already find angle between these two lines. These angles same as the angle between these two lines. Okay? So we can write tan theta is equal to mod of 2 root x square minus ab whole term divided by a plus b. Okay? Now see the third remark. Conditions for. So in that case, this equation represent a pair of lines. Suppose the given two lines are perpendicular. See, the first condition is here. Lines are perpendicular if and only. We know that the angle between two perpendicular lines is here, theta is the 90 degree. And we know that tan 90 is a not defined. And this ratio of these two तुमचा डिनोमिनेटर हा ज्यावेळेस 0 असतो त्यावेळी ही व्हॅल्यू तुमची काय येते नॉट डिफाइंड म्हणजे लाइन्स जर परपेंडिकुलर असतील तर a plus b is equal to we get a 0 इन दैट केस c वी कैन राइट theta is equal to here 90 degree ओके नाउ सी द सेकंड कंडीशन इज लाइन्स आर पैरेलल okay, suppose the two pair of lines are parallel, we know that the angle between two parallel lines is here 0 degree, okay, theta is equal to 0 degree. Now, put theta, in that case we get a tan 0 is a 0 and we know that ratio of two number is, jave tumcha numerator 0 asto, tyave tumhala ya don termcha ratio ha kay mito 0 mito. So, after simplifying this condition, we can write the lines are parallel if and only if x square minus ab is equal to 0. Okay, now see the third condition is lines are intersect. Lines are intersect each other. If x square minus ab is strictly greater than 0. So, in that case, the pair of lines, samja parallel nahi yet and perpendicular nahi yet. Means that kasha asnar ahe, they are intersecting each other. After satisfying the condition, x square minus ab is greater than 0. And the coordinates their point of intersection. The दोन lines are intersecting असती, तर त्या ज्या point मध्ये intersect करतात, त्या point चे coordinate आपल्याला मिळतात HF minus BG divided by AB minus H square is the X coordinate and Y coordinate is here GH minus AF divided by AB minus H square. These are the coordinate of their point of intersection. Okay. Now first of all write down these three remarks. Now see the next remark is remark number 4 is the combined equation. Combined equation of the combined equation of the bisector of angle. The bisector of angle between the line AX square plus 2HXY plus BY square is equal to 0 is X square minus Y square divided by A minus B is equal to XY divided by X. Suppose the two pair of lines, these two are the pair of lines, they are passing through your origin. Now, for finding the equation of angle bisector, here is the first angle bisector of these two lines, here is the second angle bisector of these two lines, and the equation, combined equation of these two angle bisector, we have to find using x square minus y square divided by a minus b is equal to xy minus h. And this remark is useful for JEE. Okay. Now, in that case, suppose these two lines are perpendicular. Okay. Here, these two lines are perpendicular. We know that the lines are perpendicular. Coefficient of x square plus coefficient of y square. Sum of these two coefficients get 0. That is, we already find the lines are perpendicular. A plus b, we get a 0. Hence, after satisfying this condition, these two angle bisectors are perpendicular. Hence, the angle bisectors are perpendicular to each other. Okay. Now, first of all, write down all these remarks.